Hello to you, friends. This is La Puerta de October 2017. It marks the end of my range retreat, the monks' range retreat, yearly monks' retreat, and the start of the Katina month, where usually the lay people give robes to the monks. Time is 1:30 at night, and happily I have rebooted an old habit that I started when I was a layman. That is to stay up all night on all observance days, Uposatha days. That is all new moon days and all full moon days on the month. This means twice a month, every fortnight, to stay up whole night long and practice. So I'm very happy about this decision that we put a little light on here, a torch. I'm very happy about this decision because then it's good once in a while to reboot the practice. Why is that so? Because there's a natural tendency to fall into complacency, especially laziness. Let's take a walk outside here at night in the jungle. It's good I put up the fence because otherwise the leopard could come in here. So there's this tendency to complacency, and because there's this natural tendency to laziness and complacency, then one's practice tends to degenerate over time. And therefore it's good to kind of like reboot it once in a while. So to get up to a higher state of training. Why is that good? It is good because then one can make the practice more intensive and thereby reach higher. What one doesn't realize by this slow degeneration of the practice, which in the early Buddhist practice is called backsliding. And this is a very good expression because backsliding actually is what happens. So you don't realize it, but slowly one backslides back into lower degrees of freedom, lower degrees of happiness, and lower degrees of morality, of sila. And because it so happens that this practice become lower and lower, then one's future rebirth is also falling to lower states. Since it is so, then it's important to reboot this practice once in a while. And I can recommend again, actually I started this practice before I became a monk. Then we would stay up all night, some friends and I on the internet, and then we would check in upon each other during the night, and then one typically do one third of walking meditation, typically when you're starting to become tired and fall asleep, then up, take some cold water in the face or take a bath like I just did, a midnight bath. And then go up, get up and going. And then after the going, then one can do sitting meditation. After the sitting meditation, one can do Dhamma study. either listening or looking at Dhamma videos or reading the text, the Tipitaka text. And one will feel, immediately feel, ah, okay, this is something right. This is well, the feeling I feel now. Ah, this is something that is good to do. It's very advantageous to reboot one's practice again by taking up this rule of not sleeping, staying up all night long, twice a month. In the old days, for example, Anuruddha, the great master of awareness during the Buddha, he never lied down for the last 25 years of his life. And also he never slept. And this was fairly common among the Arahants. It's one of the Dutanga practices, never to lie down. So if he could do it for 25 years in a row, then we can also do it twice a month. Stay up all night long and only do training, Buddhist training. And of course, we will be a much better Buddhist and much more happy beings, much more clever beings, much more alert, acutely alert and aware beings by this practice. So I hope that you also will take up this practice of staying up all night long, practicing twice a month, every full moon night and every new moon night. Thank you for your attention, clever consideration, and kind contribution. And from here, Cyprus Hermitage, on full moon night, October 2017, Roger, over and out.
You heard Bhikkhu Samahita from the Cyprus Hermitage on the Knuckles Mountain, Pampalela, Central Hill Country, Sri Lanka. Please subscribe to the Google group Buddha Direct and visit the website whatbuddhasaid.net. May all beings become thus happy thereby. Thank you. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha. As the next Buddha, the noble Arya Ajitamitaya will say, you can come as you like, but you pay as you go. Thank you for your contribution and have a nice day.